but to also have something, some guardrails if you want in place to be like, hey, no, like, you know, clean this up, please. And then I don't have to feel bad because it's just a piece of software that yelled at them. So I'm like, and usually what's cool about this is like, if you're a group of developers that want to implement this, like, you're kind of in it together to do it. Like, it depends how you communicate, obviously, but the way I manage people, it was always about like, hey, don't we all want to build the best code that we can? Like, let's give ourselves the tools and the way to do it. And that's kind of how I got into this idea of CI. And if we don't have too many questions, I can show, I have actually a kind of live example of CI that I can show as well, to just show also another kind of pain point that I use CI with. Well, it's more like continuous deployment, but I can show that as well. Yeah?
Do any of the tools that you mentioned have Slack integration?
Oh, that's actually a super good question. I should have mentioned that. So the question was, does any of the tools that I mentioned have Slack integration? I can't confirm, but I would be willing to bet my hand that they probably all do. Maybe exception might be like Bitbucket, because they don't want to play nice with Slack and they'll just do it for HipChat, but I feel pretty confident that they all have it, because it's just, we all work in Slack. I can definitely tell you that CircleCI has it, because I use CircleCI with Slack, but yeah, if you wanted...
Bitbucket does integrate with Slack.
Okay, Bitbucket integrates with Slack, so...
GitLab
with Slack. Okay, so we've already covered three. I know Buddy actually does it from my research, so, and Travis as well. So, yes. So, we did it, team. yes, they integrate with Slack. Any other questions? Yeah?
Carl, so with this kind of process, like, this is obviously for something in more of like a team-based environment, but if you're like a solo...
Yeah.
You know, developer, is this something that we
can
take advantage of?
So let me try to bring it up. I'm super bad at managing. I might just use the screen mirror. Just a second. So I think that's an excellent question. So the question was, what do you do if you're a solo developer? Like, why would this be useful to you? And okay, let me bring up the mirroring. So I want to show a bit. So this is GitLab, CircleCI. So what is this? So recently I built my first plugin on the plugin directory. And I don't like SVN, I don't want to use SVN. And I wanted to have this managed completely automatically. So I'm actually writing an article on this. It's not part of this one, but it'll come out probably within a month, where I explain this entire thing with CircleCI. But what this does here is it runs, so this deploys your plugin automatically to the plugin directory. So I'm solo, I'm managing this plugin, I want to do new releases and things like that. I want to automate everything around that and do my testing, and do my acceptance testing. So this is actually what it would look like. This is what it looks like with CircleCI. So so you start over here, and it builds, so there's a separate process, because it's not tied to anything else, it runs on its own, but if you're familiar with the WordPress directory, you can have assets like icons, the label on top, the image on top. So this job here will deploy that automatically for you separately. But here we have the standard build process that I was talking about. So we check out the code. We're doing a bunch of things with it so that if we continue using it, I use Composer, so pulling Composer dependencies, things like that. So it does all of that. Then runs code quality checks. Then we have what they call with CircleCI is a fan out. So at that point, once the code quality checks are passed, it'll run all your unit tests in the different PHP versions for you separately, and it'll run them until they pass. And once all of them have passed, you fan make sure WordPress installed, MySQL database, and then I run some acceptance testing on my plugin to see is it doing what it needs to do. If it does, perfect. I start deploying the plugin to the directory, and that's all done automatically. So if I tag a new version, it'll run all the tests. If everything's green, it'll deploy that automatically to the repo. So that's an example of what you can use it as a solo developer. And I'll be writing about that specific workflow with Circle CI soon. I'm in the process of writing that article. Yeah?
So is the code quality unique to this one, or is that part of all of them? The code quality testing?
Yeah. What about...
is that its own? Is that only on this particular CI, whatever it's called?
No, the code quality is... That's a good question. So the question is the code quality job here just for Circle CI? No, actually what's happening with the code quality step is exactly what I talked about earlier. So actually for that step, what's running is actually Grump. So Grump, I have it configured with a smaller range of tests to run for Circle CI. And Grump runs checks my code for complexity, code styling, and all that stuff. And if that fails, then that job fails. So you could do the code quality, that code quality step, you could do it with Bitbucket or GitLab or all that, because it's just Grump.
It's hard to keep track of all these names.
No, that's fine. That's fine. That's why there's an article that you can refer to. I'll be tweeting it later. But I'll explain all these tools. If you want to start with somewhere, like Grump is really the one to start with, because you can really use it as a foundation for everything else that goes after. John?
So if you're getting started with CI, and you look at something like Circle CI, and you have to pick to set up an account, like number of containers and parallelism and all that stuff,
yeah.
What's a container?
What's a container?
You're getting started, what do you need?
What does it mean?
What do you need to get started for something like this? Is a container a project, or one container across multiple projects, or
John's question was, what do you need to get started with this? So without getting too crazy in the technical, these are all kind of, this is all done through one configuration file, but what's happening on the platform is it's all Docker. So it's all containers that are running your code in an isolated format. There's reuse that you can do, and I'll be talking, when that article on this comes out, I'll be talking, at least in the context of Circle CI, a lot of the things that you can do, because you can cache things, you can, you know, save things for later, because if you build your plugin in one step, well, that container gets destroyed after. So you need your code that you built to stay somewhere. So that's part of the configuration process and all of that. But really underlying it, for all these platforms nowadays, it's all Docker. Yes?
Kind of off topic, but what is passwords evolve?
The question was, what is p3of3 evolved? So this is a small security plugin that I built recently. What it does is that it actually checks. So let's say you log in to your site and you're using a password that's appeared on a security breach before. It will either warn you about it, or it will just flat out prevent you from logging in until you change that password, and then I check as well the password. So I don't let you reset a password to another broken one as well, so I check all of that. When WordPress generates password, I'll also check those. So it does that, and then it also changes the hashing function used by WordPress to hash your passwords, so that makes it harder for malicious actors to decrypt your password if they steal your database. So that's what the plugin does.
Can you talk about code coverage? And I'm not sure if it's all topic, but what maybe percentage you would suggest for teams for code coverage?
Okay, so the question is about code coverage. And so that could be a talk in itself, because again, there are holy wars fought around code coverage versus like 100 versus. So I'm a pragmatic person, and I feel so. This is also a tangent. So one other tangent. I write a lot of object-oriented code. If you read my blog, it's like a lot of it is how to write good object-oriented code with WordPress. So in the context of object-oriented code, my view is that any public method should be tested, at least with one test. It doesn't you